And thank you there to the news desk team. And now we take a break from the news desk for our regular interview feature. And I'm delighted to be joined in the Llanelli Talking Newspaper for the Blind studio today by John Wynne Hopkins, who's chairman of the Llanelli Community Heritage Group. Hello, John.
Hello, Robert. How are you?
Good. You haven't had to come far today.
No, no, just around the corner.
Just around the corner. Queen Victoria Road, and you just scootle along and you're here. It's great to have you in the studio, John. And I feel almost as if you're almost worth two interviews in a way, that we could talk about your work with Llanelli Community Heritage Group, which we'll come to in a second. But tell us a little bit about yourself, first of all, because you've had an interest in life, I think. And if I'm right in saying
that...
did you... Your family went to the old Rhodesia, I think, when you were five weeks old?
Yes, yes. Well, in fact, I went out when I was only 5 weeks old, arriving in Africa, North Rhodesia, in the good old days. And brought up, in fact, in Rhodesia, and then returned to this country to go to Llandovery College.
Right.
So that, you know, that's basically the background, and came back to this country for my education in later years.
Yeah. And then you returned, I think, to Rhodesia. You served with the Rhodesian Rifles, did you?
That's it. I was with the Rhodesian Africa. I returned to Rhodesia because my father was quite ill at the time, so I thought I'd go back to the country. And of course, you had to do your call up. So, but I ended up in the regular army in the Rhodesian African Rifles, which was quite an interesting period in my life. And I was quite proud to serve amongst a great bunch of African soldiers.
Right. And in terms of geographical location today, now North Rhodesia is sort of Zambia today.
Well, Zambia, North Rhodesia, where I was originally brought up in Africa, is that now Zambia. And of course, Southern Rhodesia is now Zimbabwe.
Right. So a little bit of a military career, but then, of course, you've got this career, which you're still doing today, as an artist. And
Well, in a way, it came out of the military career. Met up with old friends when I came back. I was already painting military paintings for the Rhodesian Light Infantry and my regiment, the Rhodesian African Rifles, before I even joined the army. And of course, I painted for other regiments and other individuals in Africa. When I returned to this country, met up with an old army friend who introduced me to one of the regiments in the Army Air Corps. And I've done numerous paintings then for the Army Air Corps and other regiments over the years.
Right. So it's everything from matters military aviation.
That's it.
But you do also do wildlife and landscape.
I did a lot of African wildlife in the old days. Of course, I don't get back so much. I just still return to Africa, and we go into the bush on 2 week bush trips with my sister, which is absolutely fabulous. You know, when I take my daughters with me, and the wife comes as well. And we have these fabulous, really rough trips through the African bush, going right up through Botswana, through places like the Magadigadi, Okavango, Gwai River, Savuti, Chobe, all names that many people may not know.
Yeah.
But very wild at the moment, still very wild.
Yeah, so much travel, John, but I want to talk now about about what you do here in Llanelli, really. And Llanelli Community Heritage Group, I think, has been going since St. David's Day 2004, which would make it 8 years old.
Well, actually, I've just realised you were correct, because I kept thinking it was six. Maybe it's my maths. I don't know. But yes, you're right. I couldn't believe it's 8 years.
Yeah.
We've been going 8 years. You know, we formed the group back in, as you say, March the 1st, 2004. We wanted to do a heritage trail. We wanted to get something out into the community. You know, books are great, and you know, programs and whatever else. But it's all over the country now. There's this push for heritage in the community, and we thought blue plaques and heritage panels was the way to do it. So we'd been mulling over the idea for some years, actually, before 2004. And then 2004, we'd formed Llanelli Community Heritage, and it actually came from our first project, which we had a grant from Ante Taivi to do four panels, and in fact the project was called Llanelli Community Heritage, and that's how we started the whole thing.
Yeah, and these sort of interpretive panels are everywhere from sort of old castle Furness.
Yeah, that's it. We've got you got them at Furness. The first two that we did, one was at Old Castle Pond, and the other at Furness. Of course, the Old Castle Pond was important because of the old Motton Bailey Castle there, but also it was the origins of the name Old Castle. Actual old Motton Bailey Castle was the origins of it. You had Old Castle Farm, the Old Castle Works, Old Castle Road. It all originates from that particular site.
From that.
Yeah.
And they basically give a sort of snapshot of what that area means through history then.
Well, that's it. We look at about 10 or 12 subjects for that particular little area. It may be a village, you know, it may be something like Velenvol or Furness. And we look at 12 very important items for that particular area, and it gives you a snapshot of the area.
Yeah, you're the chairman, but I understand you've got a very notable president.
Yes, we're very lucky actually. We've got Hugh Edwards, Hugh Edwards, the BBC, as our president, and we are very, very honoured to have him as our president.
Yeah.
And when he does come down. I know he's a very busy man, but he did come down for our launch of the Blue Plaque book, which we did some years ago.
Right.
I think that was 2005. No, was it? I can't remember now. Yeah. But anyway, it was a while back. But he came down for that, and that was great. And he's always very supportive of the group, and I've got to give that to him, as he is supportive of the whole of Llanelli, really.
Yeah. So the blue plaques then go up on buildings which have some association with a famous person, say if somebody famous was born there, or if they worked there, or they performed there. That's the idea?
Well, mainly blue plaques were about people, weren't they? You know, but we've also got events, important buildings, and there are other items as well. But we've got a number of important characters. You know, Gareth Hughes is one of the recent ones we put up. We've put up one for Rachel Roberts. There are numbers of others that we've done, and we've also looked at the industrial history of Llanelli, because Llanelli was so famous, with the tin industry, the steel and tin industry. And you look at we've done one at Marshfield Works, the Lodge Works. And there are other places, Davin. We looked at the Davin Steelworks as well.
Yeah.
And we've tried to bring in the whole various things about Llanelli stuff in each and every area. So every area has its own little trail according to this panel, because every panel then is supported by a batch of blue plaques.
Yeah. I'm guessing it's important, because if you don't put up things like that, things get forgotten about, don't they? Because the landscape of Llanelli is changing all the time.
That is a good point. Mm-hmm. As you say, the landscape is changing. There's such a need to remember what was there, I feel.
Mm.
And we're coming up with new things all the time. It's phenomenal interesting things we are finding. You know, our vice chairman, Lynn John, is a great researcher of Llanelli history. And the very interesting and new things that he comes up with is absolutely amazing. You know, and a lot of it is groundbreaking work, actually.
Yeah.
Very groundbreaking.
Yeah. Oh, that's excellent. And how does somebody go about getting a blue plaque then, for if there's somebody from history they want to?
Well, we've had the individuals approach us about blue plaques. What we'll do, we'll look at the criteria then. We've got to make sure that it is an important plaque, and because we can't just put them up for any reason.
Yeah.
In fact, we were approached by English Heritage 2 years ago, and then we're now in their latest publication, and they've said that we are a group of good practice, because of the way that we've stuck to our criteria, and they were quite interested in the way that we've brought in the educational element, brought in schools, and the fact that we do models, in the museum, and the various other things and presentations that we make to the community. We've sort of expanded on and created a project around the blue plaques, which has incorporated, the panels and everything else.
I'm guessing that yourself and Lynn John also do quite a bit of public speaking and take.
Well, that's what I was saying. We do a lot of talks in the community as well. And we talk to various elements of the community as well as the schools as well.
Right. I mean, it's a very worthwhile task. I mean, it's preserving a lot of Llanelli's past, and lots of things get forgotten about nowadays, don't they?
You are right.
Yeah.
And I think what's nice is to put it back in the community so that it's remembered within the community itself.
Yeah.
And, we've had such a great pleasure doing it's a hard job, and it's a lot of work involved, and we are all volunteers. We don't get paid or anything.
Yeah.
And what we do, we look for grants. We're very lucky that we get sponsors as well. So we've got a lot of individuals in Llanelli who've sponsored plaques, individual plaques. So if there's anybody out there who wants to sponsor a plaque, they're about £320.
come your way.
And we've got a good list. We've still got a list at the moment. We've got a list of about 16 that we still want to do.
Oh, that's great, John.
Yeah.
Well, many thanks indeed for coming in to talk
pleasure,
to us.
Pleasure.
And hopefully we'll talk to you again in a little while about further progress with the Llanelli Community Heritage Group.
Thanks very much, Robert. Thank you.